Hello guys, let's start basic beginner to intermediate yoga class. Just going to start with some warm-ups. So I just want you to sit straight with your legs shoulder width apart and bring your hands behind so that you can sit tall. Just all warming up, connecting to our body. So just want you to look at your toes and slowly start moving your toes and then start focusing onto your breathing. Breathing in through your nose and out through your nose. Just inhale slowly and exhale. And just moving your toes. And now just from the toes we're going to onto our feet and our ankles. So just breathing in as we're pointing. And breathing out, we're flexing. So just inhale and exhale. Inhale. And as you exhale, you flex your feet. Breathing in, start opening up. So just feel like connecting mind and body, because our mind is always busy and it's not fully alert. In the whole body, because we're thinking something else and doing something else. So just start connecting your conscious, start connecting your awareness to the distance part of your body. So just releasing tightening and stiffness from the feet and preparing the body for the nice, good sequence of the practice. So now we're going to rotate. Starting slowly and just being aware, right and left, moving both evenly, breathing out as turning in and breathing in as you're turning out and in. Inhale, exhale, inhale and exhale. Let's go to reverse, breathing out as you're turning in, inhale out, exhale. So connect with your breath, connect with your practice. Start feeling centered, start feeling focused. Now we're bringing feet closer. So just a few warm exercises and then we'll start a standing practice. So now just flex your right foot and point your left. Now keep alternating, keep changing and breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. In and out. In and out. Two more, and out, last one, and relax, shaking the legs. So we're done with the ankles, we're just going to come down to our knees and stretching the hamstrings. So make sure you're still sitting up straight. But if you're finding a tightness in your back, you can sit on a block like this. Okay, so just bend your right leg and bring your both hands behind your right leg. Sitting tall, inhaling, and as you exhale, you extend your leg. Inhale, you bend your leg. Exhale, we extend it, and inhale, bending. Making sure our back staying straight, we're sitting upright, keeping those shoulders relaxed, face relaxed. Exhaling, extending, inhaling, bending. Just last one, now just hold for two breaths, breathing in, and breathe out. Inhale in and exhale. Just give me one more breath. Keep leg lunge. Just lifting leg up, breathing in and breathing out. And just relax your right leg. Good. Take on your left leg now. Sitting up tall. Interlock your fingers. Shoulders are staying back. Sitting up tall. Okay. So start focusing, engaging your core as well. So just exhale and extend. Inhale and we're bending the leg. Exhale, we're extending. Inhale, we're bending. So start feeling we're keeping our spine upright and we're sitting up tall. Just two more. And back. Last one. Hold here. So staying here for another three breath. Breathing in deep. And then start feeling warming up. Of the muscles warming up the body in the same connecting last breath. And exhale. And now relax. Good. We're still going to stay on the knees. But just want you to stay here and just give a little massage to your knees. Just the gentle, soft stuff for the body. Good. Not just always exercising or expecting from the body, but sometimes doing something for the body. So just do other way. Good. And just gentle, soft touch, feeling relaxing, and just giving those tendons and ligaments on the knees a little massage. Good. And just relaxing. Good. All right. Now, just lift the right leg again, point your toes, and just slowly rotating like you're making a little circle with your toes. Good. Less from your hip and more from your knees. It's just all those joints or the tendons, lateral tendons, we massage, we're going to open up. Let's do other way now. And then focus on breathing. You're feeling with that breathing, you're sending fresh oxygenated blood to you, nutrition to those distant part of your body. Good. And just relax. Good. Let's massage first. Just gently, slowly, just with this part of your hands, like making a cup. And just softly massaging and breathing in, breathing up. It's really good if you look there, so that you bring your awareness, your consciousness, your attention to your leg. And feeling they are good, they're healthy and strong. Good. Okay, let's do the other way. A few more. And focus on breathing. And just softening, calm, relax. That's very good. Okay, let's do little circle. So just focus pointing your foot as I'm pointing towards you. We're still sitting straight and just doing a little circle. Just inhale, exhale this time. Good. It's not confusing ourselves. We're just concentrating. We can do circle. Okay, let's do other way. Good. And feeling knees and relax. Good. Now we've done our toes, we've done our ankle, we've done our knees. And we're going on to our hips now, so just relax. Good. Okay, so sitting up tall again, bring the right ankle up onto your left knee, left thigh, so just grabbing onto your foot and this hand up here. Breathe in, and as you breathe out gently, come down halfway. Inhale. Now, remember just the warming up, not forcing and not even thinking negative, I'm not good enough, I'm not flexible enough. That's all comes a lighter with the regular practice. So exhale, we're coming down, and inhale, we're coming. Now just one more exercise here for hips. Just do a little circle. Now, remember, I'm placing my hand up, I'm not pushing really down. And even you see my hips are really even, and that's what we're doing for hips, to get a little opening from the hips. And also being aware to not cheating with the exercise. Also want you to start focusing, if you can, engage your core. And that is we call in the yoga terminology, Mula Bandha. Mula means a base, and Bandha means a lock. So the base lock, well, that is the pelvic floor. Good, okay, now we're resting. Very good. Now, let's do it with the left as well, sitting up tall. As I'm talking, you start, you keep connecting with your breath and keep learning these new things. For me, you might have already done a few sessions with me before, but just start connecting to your body, breathing in and breathing out, we're going down slowly. Breathing in and breathing out, we're going down slowly. Inhale and exhale. Breathe in and breathe out slowly down. We're feeling, we're keeping our hips stable and we're really enjoying our practice, really working. Good. And just hold here, bring the hand up onto your kneecap. And do a slow circle. You're feeling that right hip staying stable. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in. And let's do the other way now. And exhale. Very good. As you're pushing down, breathing up, you're pushing up or lifting up, you're breathing. Good. Just last one. And rest. We call it half butterfly pose. And then the next one we're going to do the full butterfly. But this is all opening, so we're not just really holding the pose yet, because it's all we're doing is just the moving, it's the moving energy. Okay. So feet are staying here, and I just want you to feel you lifting the crown of your head up high. Pulling tummy, very good. You're doing really well. So now just lean forward as I'm leaning forward towards you. Start focusing, both hips are staying still and they're sitting evenly. Now, zipping up and start doing butterflies. Inhale, exhale. See, I'm not really forcing and pushing fast. I want you to stay still. I want you to stay connected and keep focusing, engaging your core. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Just give me one more and just relax now. Good. Okay. So less and less touching on the legs. We're working more, getting stronger. Good. Okay. So feet are legs, feet are staying together, legs are staying, knees are staying together. Good. And now we're done with the hips. I'm just coming on the side and the back. So just inhaling, staying up. And as you're exhaling, you're turning. Follow Bhunamanasana. See what we're doing here. When I'm turning, I'm trying to keep my left hip down. I want you to do the same, turn. And we'll go back to the asana, a full asana. So inhale, you're turning to the center. I feel your feet are staying even, not shifting. And as you're exhaling, you're turning, twisting first. Inhaling, and as we're exhaling, and this time, when I'm going down, I want you to see I'm not lifting my left hip, so I just want you to do the same. So as we exhale, push that left hip down and go down. Inhale, turning. Exhale, going down, and I try to push that right hip down as well. Very good. And come down slowly. Inhale to the center. And exhale, we're going on to the right. Inhale to the center. And exhale to the left. Good. Feel we're keeping opposite hip down to the floor and back. So it's not about how far you can go. It's about how much aware you are with your movement. Good. And as you exhale, pull your tummy, go down all the way. Inhale to the center. And exhale down a little further. Inhale to the center. And exhale. And relax. Good job. Good. Okay. So just a few more. And we're done. Now, just want you to sit cross-leg, but just not like this. I want you to bring your feet under your knees. And the focus is sitting up tall. And if you're tight with your hips, don't hesitate to use the block or some blanket or something. Okay. So just a few more exercises to open up the upper body now. So just want you to lift both arms up. And as you exhale, lower your both arms down. Four more. And exhale down. Three. And exhale down. And it's okay, you don't have practice to sit down across there. We will change your legs soon. And we almost done the warm up. Just stay here. And just want you to lift your right arm up. Sit tall, push the right hip down. And stretch. Good. Come back to the center, and as you exhale, you stretch. Good. Keep going. And as you exhale, you stretch. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, see as I'm stretching onto my left, I'm pushing my right hip down too so that I can create, left hip, sorry, to create a lengthening. And now I'm pushing my right hip down and back. Now we're pushing onto the left and rest. Good. We're changing the legs quickly. You see I'm not helping, but you see I'll expect you to do the same. But at the end you can help a little bit to sit. Okay, so sitting straight, preparing ourselves again, pulling, keeping tummy in, lifting the crown of the head, and turning onto the right side, and looking over our shoulder. Good, and turning. And turning. And turning. Good, it's inhale. And as you exhale, pull your tummy and focus on your mool bandha, means you locking the base lock, keeping the base lock on. And rest. Good. No. So the hands are coming here, and we're just rolling the shoulders. They cut down with the spine. Good. And just working on it. Shoulders. So just inhale, lift up. Exhale out. Just preparing from toes to the crown of the head. Last one. Inhale through your nose. And exhale through your nose. Just stay here. And just bring all thumbs forward. So it's giving you, giving me your hand to just reach. And as you exhale, and here, inhale, exhale, touch your fingertips on your shoulders. Inhale, exhale. So all the preparatory exercise. And then we stand up and do the standing sequence. One more. And rest. Then we come back here. We're just staying here. And just rotating the shoulders, lifting shoulders all the way up. And exhale down. Inhale. And exhale down. Two more. And exhale. Big circle. See, when I'm coming, I'm touching my shoulders. I'm trying to touch. And when I'm lifting all the way up as far as I can go. Reverse now. Inhaling, lifting. And exhale down. So, preparing. Warming up and opening up the upper body. Good. Last two. And the last one. And rest. Good. So now hands up onto the knees, onto the thighs, shoulders back, sitting up tall. Okay. So coming onto the neck. First of all, we're lifting the crown of our head up higher. We can feel there is no pressure on the neck now, so those vertebrae have a nice gap there. And slowly turning head up to the right. And bringing back to the center. No, let's do it on the left. Good. And back to the center. Sit up tall, go again on to the right. And back. Good. And last one. And back. Good. Now, we're looking up now. And looking down slowly. So just inhale, looking up. And exhale, looking down. Just want you to stay here. And just rotate your neck onto the right shoulder so you'll be able to see the right shoulder. And now go down and onto your left. You'll be able to see your left shoulder this time. Go down and able to see your right shoulder. And down more, seeing the left. And now come down and bring your head back to the center. So just last another 1 or 2 minutes. Sit tall again and just drop your head down to the right and back. Drop your head down to the left and back. And just two more. And back. And last one. And rest. That's very good. Okay. So just do a few more and start preparing yourself to get up. Okay? Now just relax first. Stretch your legs. Hands are behind you. Just shake your legs. See if you want to have a little drink. If you have a little drink, otherwise we'll just step. Start our standing sequence. Okay, so we're starting up with the samasthiti. Samasthiti means the preparatory stage for standing. Okay, so see, you can keep your feet together or you can keep your feet slightly apart, up to you seeing where you or how your hips are feeling. Okay, so I will keep it almost together, but see, you can keep it hip width apart. Now, I just want you to bring your arms onto the side, and I'm feeling you opening up all the toes. Good, okay. Now, what we're doing is we're extending the knees, and focusing first, stepping up tall. Now, I just want you to rock forward towards me as I'm rocking towards you. Feel your toes, your ball of the foot. And just roll slowly back onto your knees. Good. But once again, as you exhale, you're rocking towards the ball of the feet, towards your toes, and come back onto your heels. And I just want you to find the center, find the middle. Okay, now let's drop onto the right this time. Just slightly, not falling, and back. And we're rocking onto the left, and back. So just the weight bearing, feeling us. Good. And now we're feeling, we've got the four corners, front, back, side, and we're finding the center. Extending the legs, but not hyper-extending. Pulling the tummy in and pushing the hip forward, squeezing the hips. Shoulders are staying back, and we're opening our palms so your palms are facing me as my palms are facing towards you. Neck long. And pull your chin back. Stand up tall. Find the balance. It's a great breath. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Inhale deep. And as you exhale, and relax. Good. Bringing hands in front of your chest. Stand up tall. And the first pose we're going to do, mountain pose. Tadasana. So arms up. And I just want you to hold here. So we're going to join. I just want you to hold here for a little while. Feel those toes open and the legs are aligned. You're standing up tall and opening up the chest. And now you lock your fingers and turn your head and stay up. Good. Now, see, you can fix your gaze on the tip of your nose. Eyes are staying open. Just stretch the whole body like a mountain. Tall like a mountain. You know, slowly, slowly keeping heels aligned, not letting them turn out. And we're lifting up. So, holding for another two breaths, challenging the balance. Down, slowly lowering the heels down and the hands in front of the chest. Good. So we're now separating our feet hip width apart. Now see, if your feet are already hip width apart, you can keep it the same way. Now feel you gently pressing the pubic bone down, pulling the tummy. As we're stretching, the spine staying in neutral, pull the tummy and lift both arms up, stretch. Good. Keep the toes open. Now, I want you to start pushing or putting weight onto your left foot. And I'm going to drop your right arm down and stretch on the side. See, that left bicep stays slightly behind your ear, not the forward like this. But if you're finding a tight shoulder, or if you have any injury, you can always go like this. Okay? So there is a variation. You're staying here. Keep putting weight onto the left so we can help opening our left side. Now, we're coming back, inhale. Now, just balancing ourselves again, feeling both legs aligned, hips aligned, squeezing our right buttock this time, putting weight onto the right foot, and coming down slowly so that right bicep is staying slightly behind your ear. Now, that's very good. Now, remember, it's not about how far we go down, it's about lengthening those muscles, giving them life. So feel that awareness is going up towards the ceiling, not going down how far you can go. And that's a mistake. You stay strong onto your pose and feel the right foot strong. Now, let's go inhale back. Now this time I want you to stretch your legs shoulder width apart. Both arms here, lock your fingers and turn your head. Nice. So we're done with the single arm now, and we're going to do it with the double. Now put the weight onto your left foot a little more and pull your tummy and stretch on the side. Now that was going to test your strength. Because locking your arms is not going to let you go down. And now come back slowly. You can even keep your hands this way, it's okay, it's completely fine. Good, okay. Now go on to your left this time. Put the weight onto your right for a little more. And breathe. Keep pulling the tummy. And come back. Now just inhale, open up your arms. And exhale, coming down. And the legs are staying shoulder width apart. Inhaling, lifting all thumbs up. Now, just look towards your knee first and bring your left hand up onto your right shoulder and then your right arm back and then return. Pull the pen in. let's do the left side. Right hand on to your left shoulder, and then the left arm wrapping around and looking back over your shoulder. So that was a cutting chakrasana. Legs stay wide and bring your hands behind. Okay. I'll turn around, you have a moment. Okay. So legs stay shoulder width apart. And I want you to bring your hands onto your SI joint or your sacroiliac area. Hands here. Now start focusing first, tightening your buttocks. It's just opening up the front body. Now I'll show you from the side. So not rushing. Good. Now squeeze the buttocks, feel the buttocks are tightening. And pull the tummy as well. And push your hip. And lift your chest, raise your chest up towards the ceiling. Now looking up and breathing. Feet are staying aligned. I will show you the variation because, as I told you, it's a beginner, intermediate, and even advanced people can do. Sometimes it's good to connect. Yeah, so you can start from here if you're just still getting into your yoga routine. You can always keep it here, and even for a beginner, they are in a good shape. They want to challenge. You can bring your heel up onto the root of your left inner thigh. So stay here. What we're doing is not letting hip drop. So we're pushing that inner thigh and the heel together and keeping it aligned. Good. And now both hands are here and look forward, look straight. Now slowly lifting both arms up. And you can keep your hands together. Finding a little tightness in your shoulder, you can always keep your hands slightly open. Stand up tall, another 2 breaths. Okay, now come back slowly and bring your hands here and just slide your foot slowly down, legs staying aligned. Good, okay. So now remember, open up all your toes so that you have a good base support. Good. Now we're lifting left leg up and lifting and placing onto the base of our right inner thigh. Legs staying aligned and both hips are staying strong. You're feeling you're really using your core. You're really working and aware. Good. Now the practice in you do become a little harder here. Keep squeezing, shoulders and back. Let's fix the gauge and slowly, slowly lift the arms up. And breathe. This is strengthen and tone the legs, also to strengthen the inner thigh. Good for balance. And in concentration. Okay, so you can open up your arms and do a circle with me and bring your hands in front of your chest. Slightly really smile, victory. Just lost it. Good. Okay. Now, I want you to bring your feet hip width apart. Baden Angushtasana. Okay, so legs align, straight, and breathe. Hands in front of your chest, preparing yourself. We're going to go forward. Okay. We'll do twice with you. Arms up. And just exhale and come down onto our tabletop. So we're making sure we're keeping our legs aligned. Good. And I just want you to come forward. Good. Okay. So now lock your fingers. keep looking forward, and reach your arms forward and extend your legs. Good. Now be lowering that head down and then staying here. So preparing and also hold two angle pose. So just to stretch our hamstring. Legs are staying aligned. You're pushing your knees back, lifting those knee caps up and extending the legs. Good. Now put inhale, lift up. And exhale, we're coming down slowly. Let's go down all the way down this time as we are ready now. Inhale, lifting up. Now, everything's the same, so you're looking forward. Keep your back straight, keep your chest up. Pull the tension, look forward first, and just touch your fingertips down. Now, just want you to stay here and just keep looking up. Now, if you're finding a difficulty, you can bend your knees like this, or either you can use a block. But what I'm looking here is to you keep that back straight and try to make concave, so look lifting up, legs are staying straight. Now, from here, you see you can grab onto your toes and keep looking up. Now, holding onto toes but not lifting the toes, so you're pressing the toes down. Keep breathing. Keep breathing. And as you exhale, now you come down slowly. So now, from here, we're bending the knees and we're jumping, okay? Let's do once again. Good, okay, so the wide leg pose. Now, both legs together, bend your knees, and you keep your hands here, and just open and bring your arms up here. Good, okay. So, feet are staying, or turning slightly in, heels are up. Now just watch me here, we're pushing your knees back and turning your knees slightly in. Good. Inhaling, lifting arms up. Legs align. And as we're exhaling, we're coming down as we went to two angle pose. Look forward. Good. And then just touch your hands down and then start focusing again, bringing back onto a concave, looking up. Good. Now, you can always bend your knees slightly, okay? Remember, inhale, look up. Now, feel the inside of the thighs. We're working strong and your cords are tight. So breathing in. And as you breathe out, just go and bend your arms and just lower your head down slowly, breathing in, breathing out. Last one. Looking up. Inhale, going up. Push your hips slightly forward, keeping legs straight, and arms are down, hands in front of your chest. Now, legs are staying the same, and I want you to turn your right foot out. Left foot slightly turning in, but hips staying aligned. Good. Okay, so from here, I want you to see you're tightening the buttocks and staying upright. Triangle. Your hands are here, breathing in, lifting both arms up on the shoulder. Now, hips are staying aligned. Now, reaching to the right and dropping our right hand back of our leg. Everything's staying the same. Left arm coming up, holding here and turning and lifting up and be looking up towards your left hand. Good. Now, staying here. Now, making sure that right leg staying straight and really stretching that inside of the thigh. Stretching onto the hip, holding here, or the outside of the left leg. Inhale, we're coming back up. And exhale, coming back to the center. And let's do the left side. So aligning, you feel that inside of the knee is pointing to your big toe and second toe. Good. Okay, so stand up tall, align the hip. Inhale, lifting both thumbs up. Trikona. Trikona means a triangle. Stand up tall. Okay, let's go. Exhale onto our left. And we're dropping the left hand on the back of the leg. Good. Right arm coming up. Now, turning that right arm and looking up towards you. Our right hand. Now, left leg staying strong, straight. And breathe. Inhale, coming back up. And exhale, hands at the front of the chest. Now, this time we're stretching our legs a little further back. Good. Okay, so see, the right foot is turning, knees staying aligned, hips are staying aligned. Now, hands are here, and inhaling, we're lifting arms up. Yeah, so stay here. Now, go. Lunge onto the right. Good. Okay. Let's go come back again. Feeling we're keeping your torso in the center first. And this time as we exhaling, we're going down. We're going a little further down. Feel that torso staying in the center. And you're keeping that weight onto your left foot strongly here. Now from here, let's go exhale and go down. And bring your right hand back off your right leg. And your left hand here. So now I want you to go look up and stay. Now, keep your weight onto your left foot and breathe. One more breath. And drop your arm. And inhale, come back up. And turning onto the left leg. Stay staying strong. And exhale, we're lunging down. Good. And come back. Feel that torso staying center first. Good. Okay, let's go again. Exhale down. Stay up. Stay upright. Good. Go a little further. And then go down. Now, I want you to lift your right hand. Hold it here. And then go over your shoulder. And see if you can lower your hip down. Good. Looking up. So the focus here for left knee. And the left ankle to be at 90. You can touch your hand, or you can even use a block, or you can even use your elbow to stay. Two more breath. Okay, coming down, and come back up. Inhale, and hands here. So, just one more, we go do the warrior pose. So bring your feet just slightly closer, and just turn your right foot again up, and this time your left foot staying further in. Good. Okay, so now I want you to rotate your feet all the way. So staying aligned here, good, hands are here, and you inhale, lifting both arms up. Now stay there, just look forward first, and as you exhale, you lunge down. Good. Now keep weight onto your left foot. And keep pushing weight onto the back of your heel or onto your little toe. Okay. Now here, the shoulder staying in the middle of a right leg. And lock your fingers and look up and throw your head back. And coming back to the center. And we're coming back to the center and turn. Good. Okay. So you can give a little help. So turning the right foot in, left foot out. Good. And just align your hip. Good. So completely turning. So you're feeling your hips are exactly square. Good. And here. Now let's go. Inhale. Just lift your arms up and lift the chest up. Your sternum up. Hold it there. Lock your fingers and lunge forward as a warrior ready to march. Now, Push the weight onto the back of your right leg. Now, let's go a little further down. And this time, I want you to look up. And now coming back to the center. Yeah, bend the knees slightly and jump back. Very good. Okay, so just two more and then we're done. Okay, so let's sit here first together and bring your right leg over your left. Hands in front of your chest. Inhaling, lifting both arms up. Now, I want you to drop your right hand down and stretch your left. So that outside of the left, and also we're going to work on ITB. Breathe. Now see, you'll be able to see your thumb. Keep that arm straight for another breath. Go inhale up. Now, the front leg is optional. You can keep it slightly bent. You can keep it straight. Come forward. And down slowly, so look forward first. And the stretch should be on the back of your leg. And you push that hip away from you. And you're going to feel that ITB stretch. Look up. And as you exhale, you pull your tummy and lower your head down. Move forward. Inhale up. And arms down as you breathe out. And switch. Good. So this time, left leg over. Both hips are stand aligned. And here, breathing in, arms up. Chest up, reach. And just go drop your left arm down this time. Keep that right hip slightly back. As you're turning, I want you to feel that stretch on your front and a stretch on your side. Breathe. Be able to see your thumb. Inhale up, both arms in, reach up higher, and as you exhale, we're coming down. So we almost finished today's practice, just a few more, look up, breathe in, one more breath. So see, remember, I'm even keeping my legs slightly bent, but you can keep it straight if your flexibility allows, or you can keep it bent. So the focus here is to push that right hip back away. And now breathe out. We're coming down slowly, slowly down. Keep breathing. Forward. Inhale up. And arms are down, hands in front of your chest. Good, okay. So now we're coming down. It's because we've done lots of forward bending, I want to work on a opening up the back to counterbalance. So we're going to do two poses. One is Ushtrasana, it's called Camel, and then the second is Bridge. Okay, so I'll turn to you facing me here. I'll show you guys first here. So what we're doing is trying to keep our knees and hips aligned. And that's very important. We're going to work on that. So we'll do twice. I want you to keep your feet and knees hip width apart here. And flex your feet here and flex your toes so that you put the weight there. Now, start tightening the lower buttocks. And then start squeezing the buttocks. See, I'm not hyperextending back here. I'm not working on the neck, pulling the tummy in. So we create this stretch and opening those pores. So when I was saying we're contracting, we're actually tightening those. And now we're going to open up this to balance the body. So keep squeezing, keep tightening. And now bring your left hand. I Find it, right hand in, and just lower your elbows and open up your chest. So looking down in, and I want you to keep pushing your hip forward. Almost a similar time we spent on doing the camel pose. You're going to stay on the child pose to counterbalance. Good. Hold the thumbs forward, lengthening those arms. It's up to you. This is again optional. You can keep your feet pointed or as we did last time, so that's I'm going to teach you. Let's see if you have any back issue, back pain, or even hernia, make sure you're just doing the modified one we've done we did before, okay? So now for advance, you can point your feet. The preparatory is everything's for a sign. So tightening your buttocks, but pulling the tummy, arms are staying on the side this time. So two ways, you can go back like this, or I'll show you with the advanced one. So looking up, and reaching, and take your hand, or place up onto it, the sole of your foot. And bring the other hand, and back, and the sole of the foot. And really tighten your glutes, and look up. One hand forward, bring head up, and feel like you're pulling something and coming back, and back, and up. Good. Okay, so knees are wide this time, you're sitting back, reaching, arms are forward. Just let your head relax and come. We'll do two poses here, and that's the end of the session. One, we'll do a bridge, and then the second, we'll do Navasana. We do half modified, and then we do Paripurna, means the full boat. Let's see how what we feel now. So almost end of the session. So feet and knees are staying hip width apart. Open up the toes and bring hands in. Now, inhaling, lifting the buttocks, mainly first from the lower buttocks, and then pressing hard onto the heels and lifting, opening up your hips. Good. Now, eyes are still staying forward as I'm looking towards you. And squeeze the buttocks hard. And breathe. Keep opening up. Keep lifting up. And come down. out slowly. Good. Now, I'll turn around to you facing, still facing me. Knees together, feet together. Bring your hands here and lift your feet up. Good. So see, I gently went back, but I kept my back straight, neutral. And then the focus here for us is to first focusing on to Moolabandha, the base lock, and then we're pulling our tummy, our belly to the neck. So if you can control the balance, you can bring your arms onto your side and open up the chest, hold it there. And rest. Good. Let's do bridge again. As I said, we're going to do it twice. Let's see if you can now do this one. So feet are hip width apart and really point your feet. Legs are staying aligned. And now concentrate on pushing those knees down first. Arms are back and just lift your hips up. And really concentrate on pushing those feet. Hips up, still looking towards your toes first. Now, push hard onto your knees. Open up your chest as well this time. And look up, but not dropping your head down. Stay. And slowly coming down. That's very good. Now, Paripurnanavasana. I'll show you this way now and how we can modify. So this is the last, okay? We're almost finished. Up here, sit tall, and slowly, slowly extend your legs. You can bring your legs, your hands behind your calf, you can arms here, sit tall. Focus pushing those knees back, lifting legs high. Two more breaths. And rest. So now, land on your back. Legs are wide. Arms up. And your palms facing up. So now you'll relax for another 2 to 3 minutes on a shavasana or a corpse pose. Making the whole body relax, making yourself calm. And letting go of all the tightness. Making the body still. Slowly breathing in, breathing out. Connecting and making the body soft, supple. Let go all the tightness, all the tension, all the fatigue disappear. Start slowly lowering your breath rate down. And with your breath rate, start lowering your heart rate down. Just completely surrendering yourself. Completely surrendering the whole system to the universal conscious, to the God conscious. And letting go all the fight happening in your mind, all the struggle. present. Start feeling peace in the mind, in the breath, in the body. Start feeling comfort in the mind, in the breath, in the body. Start feeling rest in the body, in the mind, in the breath. That's the three, the all three uniting together. And you're feeling as one, as a whole now, the body, mind and breath all working together as one. Slowly start moving your toes, moving your feet, turning the head side to side. Take a turn onto your right side. You can keep your eyes closed if you want. Take a turn onto your right side and tuck your knees in, arms in as you move like a little baby. Just supple and soft. From outside, but strong from inside, powerful from inside, content and peaceful from outside, strong-willed and powerful from inside. Okay, so now just come and sit cross-legged. You can place your hands onto your lap, or you can place your hands onto your thighs with your hands open, or you can join the tip of your index finger with your palm. You're finishing up with the three ohms, and after three, shanti, 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 mean peace, peace, peace. Okay, breathe in. Oh.